Good morning, students. Today we will start a very common topic, very known to all, I think. This is called pronoun. So what is pronoun? We all know. So basically the definition of pronoun is the word which you can use instead of a noun. Matlab noun ke jagah mein jo use kar sakte, the word which we can use in the place of a noun, we can say it a pronoun. Okay, it's very easy. But today we are going to discuss about this topic elaborately. That means with full explanation. We know pronoun, but how many kind of pronouns are there, the different classification and their uses in proper place, we have to know. Okay, so at first we will start with the personal pronoun. What is personal pronoun? Is very, very easy. I, we, he, she, my. That means which is related with the person. That means person means a first person, I, we, second person, you, yours, third person, he, she, it. So this is very easy, personal pronoun. Next one is personal compound pronoun. That means personal pronoun ke saath jab self ya fir selves, when the personal pronoun added with self in singular number and selves, selves, then it's called compound personal pronoun. Myself, himself, herself, ourself. Okay, so myself, that means singular number, self, and ourselves, selves. So it's very easy. And ye jo compound personal pronoun hai, iska kai bhag hai. That means there are some division of this compound personal pronoun. They are, first one is reflexive pronoun. What is reflexive pronoun? Reflexive pronoun, the structure is same, just like the compound personal pronoun. Jaise ki myself, ourself, themself, himself, the structure is same. So how could I identify, how could we identify, or how could we differentiate the personal compound personal pronoun or reflexive pronoun? The difference is that the action which is done by the subject when turned back to the subject, the action which is done by the subject is turned back to the subject. Jab khud wo ghur ke subject ki taraf hi aayega to tab use hum kya kahenge, reflexive pronoun. Again I repeat the line, reflexive pronoun are also same, jaise ki themselves, himself, ourselves, all are same, but the difference is in their meaning of, in their uses in a sentence. Actually, basically the uses in sentence, I hurt myself, he hide himself. ठीक है, खुद ने हम खुद को hurt किए, वो खुद को छुपा दिए. तो जब when the action which is done by the subject turned back to the subject, this is called reflexive pronoun. Number three is emphatic pronoun. Emphatic pronoun also the structure is same, because they all are the part of compound personal pronoun. So personal pronoun, he, she, my, I, we. Okay, and compound personal pronoun, uske saath agar self ya selves aa jayega. And reflexive, same. But the structure is same, but the uses are not same. Because of the uses are not same, the meaning are also not same. So the next one is emphatic pronoun. Emphatic word se pata chalta. Emphatic word is derives from the word emphasis. मतलब जोर देना किसी भी बात पे या फिर किसी भी चीज पे जोर देना. Okay, emphasis करना मतलब जोर देना. तो emphatic, जोर मतलब पावर देना, मतलब उसको फोर्स करना या फिर जोर से बोलना, इसी को हम एम्फेसिस कहते हैं. तो एम्फेटिक प्रोनाउन आर द स्ट्रक्चर इज सेम, देर इज नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन अ रिफ्लेक्सिव प्रोनाउन और एम्फेटिक प्रोनाउन और कंपाउंड पर्सनल प्रोनाउन. ऑल आर सेम बिकॉज दे आर ऑलवेज एडेड विद द पर्सनल प्रोनाउन, एडेड विद सेल्फ और सेल्फ. सो द स्ट्रक्चर इज सेम. तो वट इज द डिफरेंस? दे देमसेल्फ गो देयर, I myself do the work. Okay, जब pronoun I, they are also pronoun, उसके तुरंत बाद जब self वाला word आएगा तब हम उसे क्या कहेंगे? Emphatic pronoun. Okay, क्योंकि वो जो I है, I myself do the work, so जो वो I है उसको कौन emphasis कर रहा है, जोर कौन दे रहा है? मैं खुद किए मेरा काम को. They themselves do the work, वो उसका काम खुद किए, वो उसका मतलब हम हमारी, मतलब उसको जो सब्जेक्ट कौन है, आई, तो उसके ऊपर जब एम्फेसिस डाला जाता है तो आई डू द वर्क, दैट इज अ कम्प्लीटली डिफरेंट थिंग. व्हेन आई से के आई मायसेल्फ डू द वर्क, दे देमसेल्फ वेंट देयर. So the difference is like that. When we use the pronoun, when we use the कंपाउंड पर्सनल प्रोनाउन जस्ट आफ्टर द पर्सनल प्रोनाउन, जैसे कि आई, उसके बाद अगर माई सेल्फ आएगा तो कंपाउंड प्रोनाउन पर्सनल प्रोनाउन किसके बाद आया, जो पर्सनल प्रोनाउन है जैसे कि आई, उसके बाद आया माई सेल्फ, सो दे, इट्स अ पर्सनल प्रोनाउन, उसके साथ ही आया देम सेल्फ, अगर ऐसे आएगा सेंटेंस में, सो दे आर कॉल्ड द इम्फैटिक प्रोनाउन. सो दिस आर वेरी इजी, बट प्लीज ट्राई टू कीप दिस थिंग्स लिटिल लिटिल एंड टाइनी थिंग्स, बट दे आर वेरी एसेंशियल एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट. ओके, यू हैव टू कीप इन योर माइंड के कंपाउंड पर्सनल प्रोनाउन जो है उसी का भाग है इम्फैटिक प्रोनाउन एंड reflexive pronoun, but the uses are not same, the structure is same but the uses are not same, that's why the meaning is also not same. Okay, next we will come the demonstrative pronoun. What are demonstrative pronoun? Demonstrative pronoun are very easy when it's particularly kisi ko agar point kare, this is your book, THIS, this is your book, and in plural form, this is your book, THESE. This then is not is, this are your book, that is your pencil. Okay, that is your pencil, so pen and those are your pencil. So the plural form of these and that this those, THIS this, THESE. When it's plural form, THESE, THAT that, and uska plural form kya hoga, THOSE. Only these four things are called the demonstrative pronoun. Okay, why it's called the demonstrative pronoun? It's particularly point out in the subject, particularly point out on the thing, so the person, so that's why it's called that. This is my pencil, so this is my pencil is particularly referred to me or the pencil also. Okay, so that's why it's called the demonstrative pronoun. This, when it's singular number, these, THES, when it is plural number, THAT, that, when it is singular cases, and THOS, those, when it's a case of plural. Okay, aur ek baat, this kab hoga wo to sabko pata hai, jab ye near mein rahega, when the pencil or the thing is just near to me or the near to the subject, when the object is near to the subject, this is this, THIS, or plural mein THES. When the object is far, when the object is far, फार मेरे से बहुत अगर दूर में रहेगा तो when the object is far far away from me, then that is the pencil, then that is the pencil. Okay, so it's not the cases right now. This कब होगा, जब ये पास में रहेगा, और जब दूर चला जाएगा तब that, अगर plural में होगा तो वही those हो जाएगा. ये सब तो हमने नीचे क्लास में पढ़ के आए हैं, तो अगेन आई रिपीट इट. ओके, सो this that those, ओनली दिस फोर काइंड ऑफ four words are called the demonstrative adjective. Okay, so it is I think very easy. And next one is indefinite pronoun. What is indefinite pronoun? This is also very very easy. All, some, many, few, one, none, this kind of jo word hota hai na, wo hum kisi particular classes ko refer nahi karte. This is a general way to refer, this is a general, all the students of the class, so it's a general way. Few of them. It's also general. कभी किसी को particularly हमने यहाँ पे reference नहीं दिया, फिर particularly किसी को point out नहीं किया गया. It refers not a particular way. It's always refers a general way. All, some, many, few, one, none. These are the pronoun which are called the indefinite. Why it's indefinite? Because it never ever refer a definite way or a definite thing, a definite person. Okay, that's why they are called indefinite pronouns. So these are very easy. Try to understand this matter, that means pronoun. So what, how many kind of pronoun we are discussed here? Again we repeat, number one is personal pronoun, number two is compound personal pronoun, number three is which is already a part of compound personal pronoun, that is reflexive pronoun and emphatic pronoun. Number five, six is demonstrative pronoun, and number seven is indefinite pronoun. Okay,